Gün dolandı dağı taşı, dinmiyor gözümün yaşı.
Doğduğumdan beri Antakya'da yaşıyorum.
I've lived in Antakya all my life. There's a serious earthquake risk here. My building's 20 years old.
20 senelik bir bina.
I've already witnessed several earthquakes here. I was very scared. I had to flee with my children. Turkey is an immense country stretching from Europe to Asia. The North Anatolian Fault crosses it from east to west. Because of its position, the country is subject to earthquakes practically every week. The town of Antakya is particularly vulnerable. Rapid urban development has prevented the local authorities from checking construction standards of new buildings.
There exists about 25,000 buildings in Antakya, and something like 50 to 60% of them are vulnerable. So they need external assistance.
After the Izmit disaster, these Turkish scientists asked for help from NATO's Science for Peace and Security program, which supports cooperation in the field of civil science. A research project was launched in 2001. Professor Güney Özgürbey and his team worked in close collaboration with major universities in Turkey, the former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia, Greece and the United States. The essential aims of the project were to assess the earthquake risk and develop building rehabilitation techniques suited to socio-economic realities in Turkey.
NATO provided financial assistance and they backed up our project. And as a result, this initiative dealing with the assessment of the seismic risk of Turkey and the rehabilitation of existing buildings.
We're back in the residential area where Hatice Altan lives. The structure of this building, typical of Antakya, is in a terrible state. The outside walls are crumbling and badly cracked from top to bottom. There are signs of dilapidation everywhere. Works must be carried out to protect the occupants.
Rehabilitation of 10,000 buildings is not easy by conventional methods. You have to speed up the process. You have to be as efficient as the other methodologies. The new methodology should be user-friendly and it should be economical.
This morning, workmen have started works to consolidate the building. They're digging a trench around the outside to strengthen the foundations with reinforced concrete. This is one of the two essential stages in the technique developed by the scientists and the engineers from private companies involved in the research project. The most important part of the work on the building is to strengthen it to resist lateral shock. To do so, we've added reinforced concrete screening all around it. The second essential stage of the rehabilitation process is to reinforce the internal structure. The workers are fixing carbon fiber sheets to the walls selected by the engineers. Two strips in the shape of a cross can withstand the swaying motion of an earthquake. This material, first used in aircraft construction, is much stronger than conventional means. Above all, composite materials are lighter than anything used in traditional methods. They don't weigh the building down, and they can be put in very quickly, so we can reinforce buildings rapidly and safely without having to move the occupants. This is the first time this technique has been used to rehabilitate a multi-story building anywhere in the world. It's the final phase of the research project conducted by Professor Özgürbey and his co-workers. They hope to persuade the entire construction sector to use the know-how. future engineers who are given this knowledge will actually be able to construct and rehabilitate buildings to withstand all manner of unfavorable conditions.
When we finish this job in Antakya, the rehabilitation work, people will then understand that this methodology is feasible, it serves for the purpose, it is fast to apply, it is user-friendly, and what else do you want more?
Spreading the results of this collaborative work should allow 75 million Turks, and by extension, all those living in earthquake-prone countries, to live with fewer worries. This strengthening work has given us reassurance and hope. We can have more confidence in the future. Hatice Altan and her family are the first beneficiaries of this research project. She's taking her children to school, relieved by what has been done to secure her home.